Here are the biggest mistakes that I see people making when it comes to preparing their conditioning plan for Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Many of the fighters that I've worked with over the course of my career have had all of these mistakes, and I see their teammates and their schools, guys at the highest level, making these mistakes regularly. So I want to break these down to help you guys not make these mistakes when it comes to your own training. So number one, too much conditioning. Guys are just doing way too much. They don't really understand what goes into conditioning and what conditioning is all about. And I broke that down for you guys in another video, so make sure you check that out so you understand all the components of conditioning. But they do whatever they think conditioning is. Maybe that's just cardio, so a lot of running and that type of long distance endurance stuff. Or maybe it's circuit training, so they're just doing tons of circuit training. And then they're using jiu-jitsu practice as conditioning, so that becomes conditioning. Everything just becomes conditioning. Their strength training, they do it really fast as a circuit. Instead of building strength, everything turns into conditioning. When you're doing too much overall conditioning, your body can't get better from that. It's just way too much, and it's too much of this stress all the time without the right recovery. So if we don't apply the right recovery and we just do too much overall and we make everything conditioning, then that's the only benefit we'll ever get, and we won't get it at the highest level because we don't recover in between those sessions. So number one mistake, just doing way too much because there is no understanding of how they should separate this stuff out and do it the right way. Number two, this is a huge one. Technical failure. People go in and do these conditioning circuits or in their jiu-jitsu training, and they don't, the only goal is just go. So it's just sloppy, garbage technique, terrible body positions, and they're just going. Oh, we're gonna go do burpees and sprawls and takedowns, and then we're gonna throw medicine balls, and we're gonna do all this crap. And they don't pay any attention to the body positions that they're in because they're so fatigued, because they have no idea how to set work to rest intervals or anything. They just do stuff. And because they're doing all this stuff with technical failure, that's what's going to carry over into competition. You're training yourself to perform with shitty mechanics, poor body positions, and poor technique when you're fatigued. And guess what? 95% of a jiu-jitsu competition is happening in a state of fatigue. So that means we have to have good technique, and we can't be training ourselves to have technical failure and have everything break down and fall apart just for the sake of conditioning. So you have to pay attention not only to what you're doing, but how you're doing it. It's very, very important because that's what's going to transfer over onto the mats. Number three, no structure or periodization. Again, most athletes and coaches have no idea what goes into creating a good conditioning plan. So they just do stuff. Show up and guys get together and we're gonna hit this thing with the sledgehammer and we're gonna throw this ball and we're gonna run up and down the hill and we're just gonna do stuff that looks like conditioning that I've seen on Instagram. And if I get really tired and I keep doing that, then maybe I'll have better conditioning. So we have no structure to the actual session itself. If we don't have a structure and a priority for the session, then we don't really know what to respond to and what we're gonna get out of that. So number one, we have to understand how to set up the individual session itself. And then if we don't have structure and periodization to the whole plan, then I don't know if I'm continuously getting better. The goal is each week I should be getting better so that when I get to my major competition, I am at the best physical shape and at my peak for all things that I'm putting into that plan. So if I don't have a long-term periodization strategy, then I'm just doing stuff and hoping that I'm getting better conditioning. That'd literally be like just showing up to jiu-jitsu and was like, hey, what do you guys want to do today? I'll do an arm bar. Okay, that was cool. Hey, what do you guys want to do today? Let's do a sweep from bottom half guard. And what do you guys want to do next week? We just keep throwing random moves together. Like, yeah, I might learn some things, but if I have a structured plan that builds one move on top of the next move, that builds on top of the next, and I have a structured learning process, I'm gonna get better a lot quicker. Same thing goes for your conditioning. You've got to have a structure for each session. You have to understand the goals and the priorities. And then you've got to have a long-term plan and periodize this so that each thing builds on top of it, the next one, so that you get to your peak at the end and we're not just guessing and doing stuff. And then last is too many mixed demands. So mixed demands means when I show up and I just do stuff, but I don't understand exactly what I'm trying to do, I end up sending all these signals to the body. So if I do some endurance type stuff and then some explosive stuff, and then I do all these things together, my body gets all these signals and it doesn't know what to adapt to. So if it gets 10 different signals and it's like, well, do you want me to be stronger or more flexible or better conditioned or better anaerobic conditioning or more explosive? I don't know what to adapt to because you're sending me 19 different signals all at the same time. So therefore, as a beginner, you might get a little bit better in each one, but then as you get a little more advanced, you just stop adapting to that. And now you're just doing stuff and you're not going to get better. Whereas if you come in and we have a very targeted approach and we're not sending 45 different signals, but we're only sending one or two, now when we have that priority, my body knows, hey, this is the demand that's being placed on my body, and therefore that's the stressor that I'm going to adapt to and get better from, and that's where I'll be able to get better long term. So I can't have 25 different signals being sent, and this goes ties right back into when I don't have a structure or a plan in place, then I'm just doing stuff, and therefore my body doesn't know how to get better or what to get better from. So those are the top four mistakes that I see people making when it comes to their conditioning plan for BJJ. So make sure you're avoiding these mistakes and setting up a good plan with a good structure so that you can optimize your performance for the long term, and when it matters most, translate that good technique and that good conditioning onto the mats in competition.